I was born under the star, never meant to journey far from all the faces and the place that I called home. And my father lived the same, and his father before him, but now I see in my son's eyes something has changed. And the smoke, it has stopped rising from the chimney up the road, and the light no longer shines over the door. Last year I lent a hand to haul the boats onto the land. They've been lying there for 19 months or more, and I wonder, will they lie there evermore? Wasn't many years ago that the men round here would go out in their skiffs and haul their traps out on the bay, and then shortly they return, loaded down from stem to stern, and way off the fish, then store the gear away. Now the waters are as barren as the cliffs that guard the coast, and catch the north wind blowing off the shore. And I wonder how an ocean turns as lifeless as a stone. And I wonder, can the sea revive once more? And I wonder, will they lie there evermore? Well, I hear some people say we'd be better off to stay ashore and train for jobs outside the fishery. Now wouldn't I look like a fool to go traipsing off to school after 40 years of living off the sea? Now my son, he's barely 21 and handy at the trawl. For years he helped me fish the Labrador. Now he's moving to Ontario before the first snowfall. Dad, there's nothing left for me round here no more. And I wonder, will I see his children born? And I wonder, will